A graphic of the Perkins logo swoops across the screen, revealing a chapter heading. Strategies for reading tactile graphics.
Sighted learners learn new information in what's called whole to part. They see the whole picture, they see all of the parts of the picture all at one time, simultaneously, and are able to tell where that fits in relation to other objects around it, for instance, size, distance, that kind of thing. Tactile learners learn in exactly the opposite direction. They learn part to whole. They get the information from what they're looking at, for instance, a tactile graphic, with whatever they're seeing at that moment. What you touch is what you see. And they have to put all of the little pieces of information together in a sequence and to come up with a whole picture. They have to build a whole picture out of all these little tiny views. So teaching students to compile that information is an important piece of instruction.
In a video clip, a young woman examines a large 3D model of the North American continent. Along with her teacher, she traces a groove that runs north to south on the map, depicting the 2,300-mile length of the Mississippi River, which bisects the U.S.
Where you start reading a graphic depends on how much the reader understands the concept, how much experience they've already had in reading graphics. If they know pretty much what it is they're looking at and they only need a couple of details, they may quickly scan the graphic and then go immediately to the key for the details. Or if they really don't know what the nucleus of a cell looks like, they may be exploring every bit of it.
I would like you next to look for the star-shaped organelle within the cell.
The science teacher asks the students to locate organelles within a cell. One of the students is using a 3D model with large, distinct shapes. Another boy has a page with raised line drawings, which has less tactile differentiation.
Whether you choose 12 o'clock or 6 o'clock, or whether you choose the most significant line that's on the graphic and then use that as sort of a starting point, sort of a home base, and looking at the graphic and always being able to come back to that piece. So you know that you've explored the whole thing. So how students approach that depends on content. How much of the content do they understand? How new a concept is this to them? And it also depends on their experience. You know, have they had a lot of experience reading graphics or have they not?
Great job, Corinne.
In a science class, students around a lab table create tactile models of a cell and its organelles using materials such as styrofoam shapes and large seeds.
A tactile graphic that's going to be readable and is going to be useful for the student has some characteristics. Actually, those have been identified through some research fairly recently, a joint project between the U.S. and Canada. The graphic needs to be non-cluttered, so it needs to just include the information for the task that that student has. So it needs to be not tactically cluttered with lots of extra stuff. A lot of things will be not that are in the print graphic won't be on the tactile graphic, but will be explained in the key.
This diagram represents a park.
Good.
In a geometry class, a young man examines a work page in his Braille textbook. On the open page, there is a line drawing of a grid. Within the grid, there are two rectangular diagrams. In the upper left corner of the page, there is a small, similarly textured rectangle explaining what the texture represents.
The more information that we can give the student, again, imparting what it is that the author intended for somebody to get from that graphic. Sometimes doing it in graphic form is not the most efficient way to do it for the reader. There are just too many details that you can't discern tactually that you need to, but they need to have the information. So it may be in the key, it may be in an introductory short paragraph before the actual key and before the graphic. I think it's important that we add those.
Fade to black.